Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the video lecture of wireless cellular and 4G LTE, module number 3, lecture number 9. Okay, so today we will see something about the downlink control channel. Yesterday, in yesterday's video lecture, we have seen about the downlink shared channels. Okay, that was the huge concept about the downlink shared channels, and other than that, the very important topic which we have covered is the multi antenna transmission. Okay, so if you want to go for multi antenna transmission or making use of more than one transmission, there are some protocols we need to follow for the multiple antenna transmission along with the beam forming technique. Okay, so yesterday's video lecture, we have seen how the downlink multi antenna transmission takes place. Now today, we will see something about the control channels. Okay, basically when it comes to the 4G LTE, there are two types of channels we have. One is the shared channel, another is the control channel. Okay, so again, both the shared channel and the control channel, they are related or they are linked with the downlink section of your LTE part. Now in this particular downlink control channel, basically this downlink control channel is, again, it is carried out over the physical downlink control channel. Okay, the earlier also it was something different called as PDSCH. Okay, it was the downlink, or you can say physical downlink shared channel. Okay, shared control channel also you can say, or simply you can call it as shared channel, but now here it is different. It is physical downlink control channel. Okay, and they contain some control information from the MAC, that is medium access control layer, including the downlink control information, we call it as a DCI, and some control format indicator represented by CFI, and the last is HARQ indicator represented by HI. Okay, so if you look at this particular figure number 7.11, okay, there are two layers which are shown in the figure here. One is the control information related to the downlink control channel, and another is the physical channel. Okay, physical channel is completely different from the control channel. Okay, because control channel, it consists of many informations, but the physical channel, it only consists of the some type of protocol mechanisms. Okay, or simply you can call as the informations related to the transmission. Okay, so therefore, if you look at this particular line here, okay, so this physical control channel is related to the physical layer of the model. Okay, and that model, it consists of some control informations. Okay, which are coming from the above layer. Okay, that is why I say it again and again that all the informations will be coming from the above layer, not from the below layer. Okay, if you want to transmit some information, it will start from the upper layer to the bottom layer. Okay, for example, we have the model of OSI layer, right? It starts with the application layer and it will end to the physical layer. So therefore, all the control information related to the data transmission will be coming from your MAC layers. Okay, which includes the downlink control information. Okay, and some control format indicators and also HARQ indicators. You can see these three circles, DCI, CFI and HI. Okay, and the control mapping, how the control mapping is done with respect to the physical channel, there should be something called as a mapping. Okay, there should be some technique should be involved for the mapping of the channels. Okay, or mapping of the information from control to physical. So therefore, the channel mapping control between the control information and the physical information, you can see the three different lines which are interconnected to each other. Okay, they need to represent some information. They will represent some kind of information between these two particular control and physical channels. Okay, now there is a specific physical channel for each type of control information. Okay, so other than the control information, there is something called as a specific physical channel for each type of control information. Okay, and when you take it to the physical layer, okay, physical layer of the data link or physical data control channel, okay, and the physical data shared channel, you can see here there is a difference. Okay, PDCH, it is PDSCH. the middle letter, okay, this is the control and this is the shared channel. Okay, once it comes to the physical layer, okay, they should be multiplexed. Okay, and we know there are various techniques of multiplexing. Okay, for example, we have time division multiplexing, frequency division multiplexing. Okay, we have orthogonal. Okay, we have the co-division multiplexing. Okay, but now here the both the shared channel, both the control channels, whether it is a control part or whether it is a shared part, okay, both the channels, they are multiplexed in time. Okay, so that is why they are time multiplexed, such that the PDCCH is carried over the first few OFDM symbols. Okay, we have seen a very in the various video lectures, okay, where what is happening is, if you want to transmit some information over the long distance, okay, we cannot transmit at a stretch. Okay, what we basically do is, we basically go for the division of blocks. Okay, we divide the blocks. Okay, then what happens is, we assign some kind of the cyclic prefix, right? And then when it comes to the transmission, we will modulate. Okay, which type of modulation we are again adopting here is, we adopt the mechanism of OFDM modulation. Okay, we try to go for OFDM modulation, and then later we will switch for the transmission. Again, it matters whether it is a single transmission of single antenna transmission, or whether it is the array of transmitting antennas. Okay, so therefore we should be very clear, okay, before the transmission. So therefore, before multiplexing of these two channels, the control channel and the shared channel, it has to be carried over the first few symbols, not all the symbols, initially beginning part of the symbol transmission. Okay, so this will be carried out at the beginning of, or the first few OFDM symbols of each subframe. Okay, because OFDM symbol consists of subframes, right? We have a start bit, we have a data, then we have a cyclic bit, we have some kind of redundancy bit, right? So it has to be carried out over the first few symbols of each subframe. And what about SCH? You can see there is a difference. The controlled channel has to be carried out over the first few symbols, but the shared channel is to be carried out at the rest of the symbols. In the sense, first few symbols are assigned for the control part, and the rest part is assigned for the shared part of the symbols, or shared part of the channel part. Okay, therefore this is how we go for the division of block of OFDM symbols. Okay, and the very important thing here is, the number of OFDM symbols, okay, the allocated for the control channel can vary from 1 to 4. Okay, that is what they, now you can guess what will be the size of the control symbol part. Okay, it is from 1 to 4, in the sense 4 bits. Okay, and those 4 bits will be varying all the time, in the sense from 0000 to 1111. Okay, so in this way, the control part or the control channel, the symbols will be allocated to the control channel from 1 to 4. Okay, and it is conveyed by the CFI, that is called as a control format indicator. Now this becomes my format. Okay, that is 4 bits becomes my format, and this part will be conveyed by this CFI. Okay, and what this CFI will also do is, the CFI is carried on at another control channel known as physical control format indicator. Okay, here you can see, okay, DCI, okay, is being handled by DDCCH, that is nothing but physical data link control channel, DCI. Okay, but CFI, that is control format indicator, is handled by the different channel on the physical layer. Try to listen very carefully. CFI on different physical channel, represented by PCFICH. Okay, so that is nothing but physical control format indicator channel. Okay, and which is always carried out on a predetermined format over the first symbol, OFDM symbol, for each frames. That is what the important factor is. It is control format, it is not the shared format. Physical shared format will be different, control format will be more different. Okay, so therefore, when it comes to the PCI, it is being carried out over the predetermined formats, which are already been defined by the system. okay, and this predefined, predetermined, whatever which the symbols which are being determined for the transmission, okay, formats, they also allow each user entity to decode the CFI without ambiguity, and thus determine the number of OFD symbols in the beginning of each frame that are used as the control region. So this is the procedure, whatever we have seen just here in this particular paragraph, they are nothing but the procedure. It's a kind of a procedure, okay, and this procedure will be adopted in our LTE system. The mobile phones which we use, it's a 4G LTE, okay, it's a 4G LTE mobile phones, right? Now after a few days there is a fifth generation called as a 5G, okay. This 5G will be more advanced than compared to 4G mechanisms, okay. So in this way we try to analyze the downlink control channels, okay, by step by step or by layer by, you can call it as a layer by layer also, both are correct, okay. Now when you go in detail of this DCI, that is called as the downlink control information, right? Now what this downlink control information consists of, okay, it consists of some kind of formats, we call it as a DCI formats. Okay, there are various DCI formats are available when it comes to the LTE, because this LTE is making use of your MIMO transmission, because multiple inputs and multiple outputs. Okay, so when you make use of this MIMO systems, okay, the DCI, whatever what it does, it carries the downlink scheduling the assignments, in the sense some assignments will be pre-scheduled before downloading or before downlink transmission receptions. And some kind of uplink scheduling grants, it will give the permission for the uploading part. Then some kind of power control commands and other information necessary for the scheduled of user entity to decode. Everything is used for the decoding purpose. And then always remember, whenever you upload, your data will be encrypted, and whenever you download, your data will be decrypted and it will come to you. It will not directly come into your encrypted format, okay? Because the transmitter and the receiver, they are built in encryptor and the decryptor. They are built with, inbuilted with some encoder and some decoder. So encoder will does its operation, decoder will also do its own operation. But the encoder and the decoder needs to be synchronized with each other by sharing the common key. We call it as either public key or we call it as a private key. But in general, we call it as only a key. Okay, so this is how we go for encoding and the decoding mechanism of the LTE system. And there are various formats, okay, which is shown in the table number 6.1, in chapter number 6 also, okay, which defines some around 10 DCI formats for different transmission scenarios. Okay, so let us see one by one how the various DCI formats are shown here. Okay, so there is one table here, okay. There are, so which type of information or transmission they are carried out, okay. So the very first is DCI format 0, just a name is given like DCI format 0, format 1, format 2, okay. So this format 0, it carries the uplink scheduling grants and some necessary control information for uplink transmission, okay. And DCI format 1, 1A, 1B, 1C and 1D, this will provide the scheduling information, because already you have scheduled, for example, you just take an example of the Zoom classes or Zoom application, right? There is a folder, there is a tab called as a scheduling, right? I will schedule and give you the necessary information for joining the session, okay? So that necessary information need to be provided in a proper format, right? So there is a proper format for that invitation, right? We put a name, we put a time, date, okay? Link, okay, then the meeting ID and then the password. This is how the DCI format is also, okay. It provides the scheduling information for one code word transmission without any special multiplexing, okay. Then we have a DCI format 2 and 2A, and they will provide you downlink scheduling information for CL and OL, that is closed loop and open loop spatial multiplexing, which we have seen in the earlier part of our LTE system respectively, okay. So this is the table, table number 7.10. There are various field formats for format 0. This is not for format 1, 2 and the rest all the format. This is only for format 0. Okay. If I just will not go in detail much in with this particular formats. Okay. And here you can see DCI format 3 and 3A, and they will carry some transmit power control, okay, commands for the uplink. Okay, so this is how this will just go on. Okay, this will just go on by studying the type of the fields, type of the formats. Okay, these they all are DCI formats. Okay, this table particularly indicate the format 0. Format 0, if you look at these fields, one is information, what type of information the format will consist of, how many number of bits the format is representing, and what is the purpose of that particular information. Okay, if you look at this flag format, flag we have hopping format, okay, new data indicator, TCP command, how many bits they will take, what is the space, number of bits space for that particular format. Okay, and the purpose is indicate format or format 1A, right? You people have seen in the computer networks called as a IPv4 and IPv6 format, which will be of around some 32 bits, right? So that 32 bit format, in that particular format, the very first format was the version. Okay, so that VER field, it will indicate you the type of information, okay, and what is the space, whether it is a 4-bit, 6-bit, usually it will be a 4-bit, okay, and type of information, whether it is a type 1, type 4, or whether it is type 6. Okay, so similarly, there are various formats are available with the TCP, with this DCI format. So this is for format 0, and this table is for format number 1, okay. So here also in format 1, you can see there are various information types are available, like resource allocation header, some kind of assignments, some modulation and coding scheme with, okay, the bits are 5 bits, and this modulation and coding scheme, why it is required, what is the purpose of modulation and coding scheme, okay, just to determine the modulation, okay, in order to see that your transport block size is minimum, it should not exceed its maximum capacity. Okay, so all the fields will give you some or the other purpose, and the purpose need to be served. Okay, because whenever you purchase a mobile phone, your purpose has to be served. Okay, unnecessarily we cannot just buy a mobile phone of a 2G mobile phone and we expect our 2G mobile phones to have a video call. No, not at all possible. Okay, it is only possible if you take 4G mobile phone, and then you can go for video conferencing, audio conferencing. So therefore, whatever the design you do, it should serve the purpose. Okay, so until and unless the purpose is not served, okay, the information which you provide for that particular system will completely fail. Okay, so therefore, we should be very careful while designing any of the part, any of the system blocks. Okay, so that the purpose should be served. Okay, so with this, I conclude our today's topic of our downlink control information, okay, or downlink control channel part. Tomorrow I will be in the next video lecture, I will be dealing with the channel coding and modulation related to control information. Okay, so there was something in the previous video lecture, we have seen channel encoding and modulation for the shared channel information. Now here it is control information. Okay, so with this I conclude the today's topic of downlink control channel. Thank you.